So let's just try this out. So make there my test, CD my test, and now my test TE, declare policy module. Test and just try it out. So let's just create a process type. My process T, the process or the subject, and then just create some objects. Type my object one, type my object two, type my object three. I'll just try to use only three. So now let's create some attributes. Type attributes, let's be more specific. So let's just declare attribute my attribute one, and another one, my attribute two. And then let's just associate my attribute one to both my object two and my object three. So let's just do that. Type attribute my object two T. Let's see, this probably won't work, but we could try it. See, brace expansion, my object three T, and then my attribute one, and it's type attribute. So, my object 2D has both, my 2T and my object 3T are both my attribute 1, and then here my object 3T is my attribute. Right, and then type attribute my object 3T my attribute 2. And then let's just create a rule, allow my process T my object one T file everything. My process can do all on my object one T file. my process T can read, get attribute all files that are both my that are my attribute one. So allow my process T my attribute one file read get attribute and my process T can write all files that are my attribute 2. So my allow my process t my attribute 2 file right. Now I'm not sure if this is actually buildable because we'll see. Make f user share as Linux dval make file my test. We have a syntax error on line 16. This is not going to work. So we need to do this in a separate line. The brace expansion doesn't work seemingly. Oops. I already thought that wouldn't work, but asimodule or sudo asimodule e my test p. And let's load this into the system and then just have a look at SE search and see if this actually if the results are actually what I expected to be. It might not. Let's just have a look and not speculate. All right, so SE search. Let's just look at all the rules where the source is my process key. And then just less, back that to less. All right, so here we have the rules. So what this says here is that my process can do everything on my object 1, T type. It can only write files with my attribute 2, and it can read write files with attribute 2. Now let's have a look at how that for example works. So we know that my object 2 underscore t has both my attribute 1 and my attribute 2. So let's SE search a as my process t and then target my object 2 t, and let's do this doesn't make sense. Let's have a look at the policy again, because that doesn't make sense. We have my attribute 1. Oh, actually, it's my object 3 that has both right. And, you know, so that's I did this wrong here. So you can see that my object 3 can both be read and write and get into the write my process. Now let's just edit the policy a little bit and just say that, for example, my object 1. Let's just associate my object 1 as well. So let's just my object 1 is also attribute 1 and attribute 2. Now let's see if anything changes. Type attribute my object 1 t. And then t my attribute 1 and then also my attribute 2. and then just build it, and then as you module it again, and then you'll see that nothing changed with regards to my object 1 underscore t. It can still do everything because we have a rule that where we refer explicitly to the type, and so that overrides the attribute. It's now basically the attribute associations are basically duplicate because. So let's have a look again at here. So nothing has changed for my object 1. You can still do read, write, everything to it. So, and this is basically how you test it. You just write simple rules in the module and just load it into the system, like the rules like this, and then just use SE search to see what the results are. And that's basically how you test that out.